you hear a lot of horror stories about the past female engineers getting disrespected. Hi, my name is Adila. I'm a licensed aircraft engineer. Today, I'll be explaining my job to a kid, a Gen Z, and a senior. I hope that they can understand more about my job, so let's get started.
Hello, my name's Ayden. I have some questions for you.
Okay, go ahead.
What is your job?
So my job is a licensed aircraft engineer.
Do aircraft engineers build aeroplanes from scratch?
Okay, that's quite a misconception. We don't build the aeroplanes from scratch, but sometimes we take out so many things from the aeroplane, it feels like we are rebuilding it.
What is a hangar?
Okay, so a hangar is a very large building. It's a very large empty building with a lot of floor space, and then you just put the aircraft inside it.
What is your favorite aeroplane?
I really like the 350, the Airbus 350, because it's very, very pretty. Its winglets are very nice, and it always looks like it's wearing sunglasses because of the visor.
Why are most aeroplanes white in color? Is there any reason for this?
Okay, aeroplanes are white because white actually reflects light and heat the most, which will keep the aircraft cool and it becomes more efficient. Also, aeroplanes are white because do you know that actually white is lighter than black colored paint?
Yeah.
Oh, you knew that? You're very smart. So yeah, so white is actually lighter than other colored paints, and this directly translates to the entire aeroplane being lighter, and lighter planes means less fuel. Less fuel means less cost.
Does the size of the aeroplane affect your work?
The size of the aeroplane doesn't really affect my work. It's just if it's a bigger aeroplane, things are bigger and things are higher. So I just have to climb up more. But other than that, there's nothing.
What's your favorite part of your job?
My favorite part of my job is being able to work on the aircraft.
Why did you choose to work as an aircraft engineer?
I wanted to become an astronaut. And then they said that because of my height limitations, I can only become an engineer in space. So I decided to take engineering. And then I took aerospace engineering. And then I realized that in order for me to work for NASA, I have to be a US citizen. So that dream went away and I became an aircraft engineer instead.
Are there different kinds of aircraft engineers?
There are many types of aircraft engineers. There's the airframe engineers, which normally handles the main structure of the aircraft. And then there's the power plant engineers, who handle the engines and also the APU at the back of the aircraft. There is the avionics engineers, who handle the electrical components of the aircrafts. That's mostly it. So Ayden, is there anything else you'd like to know about my job?
Do you panic while doing your job?
I don't panic, but when things happen, I get a little bit scared. I just have to try and maintain my composure, and then I do my job. So after this conversation, do you think that you learned anything about my job?
Yes, I did learn a bit more about your job. Thank you.
Welcome.
Hi. Hi, my name is Elina, and I have some questions for you if you don't mind.
Oh, of course. Please sit down.
Is your schedule very hectic on a daily basis?
I am more towards the heavier maintenance side, so my schedule is pretty routine. I'm on a shift basis, but there are days when it gets very hectic, when things happen unknowingly. Those are the days where you literally will be running around trying to find solutions. Yeah.
So does your work get extra scrutiny after news of a plane crash?
So my work is always under scrutiny. Let's say it's a maintenance problem. There will be bulletins to tell us like, okay, you have to watch out for this, or you have to inspect this even more thoroughly. So from there, then we try to avoid the same incident from happening in the future.
How does it feel like being a woman in a male-dominated scene?
Well, you hear a lot of horror stories about the past female engineers getting disrespected. But I feel that times have changed quite a little bit. People are much more open, much more respectful. My work will speak for itself, and if my work is poor, then I will get criticized. If my work is good, then I will get praised.
So it's not about gender at all?
Nothing
about
gender.
Just about performance?
Yeah.
How did you prepare to be an aircraft engineer?
After graduating, I will have to go through a 44-month training, practical work, theoretical work, on-job trainings as well. So after that, then I will get my authorizations. After that, it's all your own learning and recurrent training from the company itself. It's definitely something that you have to endure. If you want to do it, you have to be really interested in it, passionate about it. Otherwise, it's just going to be quite hellish to go through.
So is that how you keep yourself motivated? Passion?
Yeah, I guess so. At the end of the day, it really matters how we see our own work. If I'm passionate about it, if I see meaning in it, I will try my best to overlook a lot of the setbacks that I might be having. So, Elina, have you had a chance to learn more about what I do for a living?
Yeah, I think it's kind of cool, you know.
Oh, thanks.
Like, especially as a strong woman like you in an engineering kind of industry. So, I think it's pretty cool.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Hi.
Hi.
Hi. How are you? I'm Sally.
I'm good. I'm doing good.
I'm ready to ask you some questions.
Alright, let's go.
What is the common misconception about your job?
That we know how to fix everything on the aeroplane.
Oh, right, yes.
The way we work is more like doctors. We see the symptoms of the aircraft. Okay. And then from there, we will go to the manual or any reference documents to see how we can troubleshoot the matter. And right. From there, then we resolve the problem.
Like if there are mistakes at work, more serious, right?
Okay.
Because you're responsible, right? For the safety, for the standards.
Any mistake that we make, as long as we are working on the aircraft, can lead to a grave mistake. So either airplane crashes or even something minor like aircraft damages.
What do you think is the future of air travel?
Air travel, like every other industry, will definitely be towards the direction of efficiency, eco-friendliness. When it comes to like bigger planes or faster planes, it really depends on the requirements or the demands of the companies or the airlines.
So how do you stay updated?
So I'm quite new as an LAE. The first few aircrafts that I work on are technically already considered new technologies. As long as there are big changes in the industry, the company does provide ample training and they will ensure that you know what's going on and all that. Before we end, is there anything else you'd like to know about my job?
How many female aircraft engineers do you have? Are you the only one?
No, of course not. There are female aircraft engineers. Yeah, we are very
male-dominated
profession. Correct. We're a very small percentile, but it's up and coming. More females are coming into this industry.
It's such a technical world there, of course the responsibility is so great.
Yes, correct.
I mean, for us laymen, it's like, wow. It's really something so admirable.
Thank you very much. Thank you. I feel good being able to answer their questions and their queries. I feel a little bit bad that I have to be a little bit technical, so they might not understand the full picture. But other than that, I think it's quite enlightening. It would really help a lot if the public really understood what we do. So the next time you're taking a flight and the aircraft delays, try to understand that we are doing the best we can to solve the issues. So if you're aspiring to be an aircraft engineer, you have to be prepared for a lot of the challenges, a lot of the obstacles that you are going to face. You should be more or less okay with getting dirty and greasy and all that as well. I hope you've learned more about what I do as a licensed aircraft engineer. Thanks for watching the video. Bye-bye. Do you really know that white paint is, like, in terms of weight?
Weight?
Like, black paint is heavier than white paint. Do you know that? I'm so shocked when you freaking knew. Lighter color.